You're molding and shaping your own life. And one of the things that Jesus came for is to conform us into his image. We sang that song. And we're being conformed into his image. That means that Jesus is the potter. We're the clay. He's going to, this is where I want to work right here. Starts working in it. Amen? But see, you know that vessel, that pot, all right, it's got to crack. If pride is there, it's got to break. It's got to come into brokenness. And then when you do, you'll enter into true humility, the humility of the Lord. You know, the Bible talks about false humility. And I come across a lot of those people a lot of times. Instead of somebody like myself, I use myself as an example, filled with faith, filled with all believing, that all things are possible for those who believe. Hallelujah, that's the way I am. Tough if you don't like it. I'm sorry, I'm not going to change my way. Because it's the Bible way.
Yes, hallelujah.
I believe all things are possible for those who believe. I'm a believer. How about you?
Yes.
Are you a believer?
Yes.
Believe. When you begin to believe, you'll start to see God move with signs and wonders in your life.
Yes, hallelujah.
Oh yeah, it all opens up.
Yes,
start to believe.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wigglesworth used to say, in his meetings, he'd say, only believe. And then he'd sing the song. Only believe, all things are possible. Only believe. What, how's that song go?
Only
believe, only believe, all things are possible. Only believe. They sing that song, all of a sudden miracles break up.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Just like they have in here in the last couple weeks.
Yes. Amen. He's walking.
Hallelujah. Why is it miracles? Why are these miracles happening? Because we're believing. We believe.
Yes.
And we yield to the Holy Spirit. Let him have his way.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Amen. That's right.
I'm under control of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Keep praying for me. I thank you for your prayers. I tell you, I really do. I really appreciate your prayers. I really appreciate your prayers. Praise God. And I'm praying for you. Together, we need to pray for one another to obey, in order to obey the commandment to pray for one another. It's Jesus' commandment. Hallelujah. Pray for one another. When we do, we'll find some real security in the presence of the Lord that comes upon our lives. And life becomes easier. Hallelujah. When we trust in the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. That's what it's about. Praying for one another, accepting one another, loving one another. Doesn't matter where we're at in our walk with Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Helping one another if there's certain needs that can be fulfilled. You know, that's the way it ought to be. Love.
Yes.
Love. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Start to love on one another. Glory to God. What a concept, huh? Instead of criticism.
Yes,
criticism going on. The spirit of criticism will destroy a church, literally. Destroys the church. And the spirit of gossip is the spirit that likes to invade churches. You know why? Because it removes the message of the Holy Ghost to every single one of us in here or there or wherever. Hallelujah. Just recognize it when it comes your way. Say, no, I don't want to hear that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Deal in facts. Don't make assumptions. There's going to be a lot of stuff that's going to be flying through the air. Just watch it go by. Shield of faith.
Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Which is able to quench every flaming dart of the devil coming my way. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Put up that shield of faith.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Ooh, get behind that. You know that shield of faith? In the book of Romans was a big shield that the Roman soldiers, they would come under that. They would come under this big shield. It'd be like this, and it would cover their whole body, and they would get down under that shield.
Mm-hmm.
And then the way they wiped out armies is they had those guys go up in front. They'd have their spears, and they would have them shields, and they would move. They would march into cities. And they would annihilate. The Roman army just would annihilate anybody. They'd have that shield of armor. And that's what Paul's saying. Take up that big, huge shield you've got. The shield of faith. And you're able to clench every flaming dart because you stay covered in it. Are you leaving, Geraldine? God bless you. Is this your friend? Is this your new friend? Hallelujah. Do you know Jesus? Hallelujah. Come up here real quick. Come on. Can I pray for you just real quick? Hallelujah. You believe in God for something? What are you praying for?
Serenity.
Huh?
Serenity.
Peace? All right. Let's pray for her, okay? Don't fall. Bless you. Bless you. Lord. Bring the peace. Manifest. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. From the top of our head, the soles of our feet. Peace of God. God, take control of your life. The area of it. It's okay. Look at me. You know him. That's all you need, is to know him. You know him. Hallelujah. This is eternal life, that they may know the one who sent me. You know him. He's your answer. Hallelujah. Bless you. Lord, bless. Let the Holy Ghost and the presence of God go before her and be upon her. In Jesus' mighty name. There you go. Oh, it's the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Receive peace. Receive peace. Amen. Glory to God. You know, the scripture says in Romans chapter 16, the peace of God will soon crush Satan under your feet. Mm-hmm. The peace of God crushes the head of Satan. It removes the chaos. It removes the chaos. God's peace. Amen. Come on, you know, when you enter into that wonderful peace, it just, you can rest in that. Amen. Hallelujah.